God will never teach you to pray. Some people say that God teach me to pray. God will never do that. God will never force you to pray. What God does is He prays with you when you start praying. You know, start, when you're starting praying, it's not easy. Yeah, it's not easy. Kwanza kuomba. You want to start praying. Yeah? You know, it's not easy, isn't it? But as you pray, you feel a strange power coming to empower you for you to pray in hours. Has it ever happened to you?
Yes.
Yeah? Yes. Preaching sense, yeah? Yeah, praise God.
Amen.
So when you pray, what the Lord does, He just comes to empower you. But God will never initiate a prayer in you. And you don't have that grace of prayers. I'm praying. Pray for me so that the Lord give me that grace of prayer, of praying. Yeah? It can never happen. Don't cheat yourself. You have to start praying. That's what fulfills the verse that says, draw near to me, and I'll draw near to you. Isn't it? Yes, I'm drawing near to God first, for God to come and empower me. But the strange part of it is, you can't search God. Why? Because He's the one searching. So, what happens is this. Let me explain this so that I may not confuse you. So, when you want to pray, you are searching God. You are drawing near to God, isn't it? So, who plants that seed of prayer unto you? The Bible is very clear. It is the Lord who gives the seed, the sower, the seed to sow. So it's the Lord who gives you that seed, who plants that seed of prayer in you first. Christ said that no one comes to me unless my Father brings him. So what the Lord does, He will just add you through a small, still voice. My son, my daughter, pray. Praise God.
Amen.
So when He urges you, it takes your spirit, your power, yeah? Your obedience. Let me put it that way. Yeah? It takes your obedience to start praying. So when you start praying, He just comes and pray with you. But there is no way you can seek God, as people say, and seek them. Okay, let us read the book of Isaiah. Is that 41:40-28? Have you not known? Have you not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, faints not, neither is weary? There is no searching of His understanding. You can't search the understandings of God. Amen. Because the God of the Bible, it's not a God of explanation. It's not a God of theology and philosophies. It's a God of revelations. It's the Lord who reveals Himself unto us. That's what happened in the Garden of Eden. It's the Lord who used to visit Adam and Eve, not Adam and Eve visiting God. Can you visit God? Amen.
Amen.
So it's God who used to visit Adam and Eve. So it's God who visits you and tells you, search me, through a small, still voice, but democratically. He can't force you. The God of the Bible is a God of democracy. Yes? But why? Because He has given you a free will to come to church, to pray, to give your offerings and tithes. Yes, you are given that free will to do so. Isn't it? It's your choice. But don't think that God will come and force you. Pray, pray, pray. No, it will never happen. Why? Because you can't understand. And you can't search the understandings of God. He's greater than you. His ways are not like your ways. And that's why you can't pray out of emotions. or let me not use Patsy. Let me use Brother A. I'm going to consider about Brother A. I'm going to match. So what will I do? This man is fighting me spiritually. I'll deal with him. In Jesus' name, this man is cursed. In Jesus' name, he will redeem. And that is to give it. Amen?
Amen.
Unless you are led by the Spirit of God. And that's why, as prophets, we see magicians. We see people who envy us. We see people who gossip us. But we can't be blessed. Why? Because we are not directed by the Spirit of God to do it. Until that day, until an appointed time comes when the Lord tells me to do it. That's when I do it. Because even if I rebuke you 10 times, 100 times, and the Lord is not in it, it is flesh, I'm telling you, I'm just wasting my windpipe for nothing. Am I making sense to someone?
Yes.
Am I making sense to someone today?
Yes.
Remember, it is not by what you do. It is by grace. There is a season that the Lord will show you things. This thing is happening like this because of this. But out of that, the Lord is not telling you how it will go. This is going like this because of this. But the Lord is not telling you how you can get out of that mess. So after seeing that, you'll come out of flesh and start rebuking this thing. Isn't it? I'm telling you, it is a waste of time. Until the same Lord who showed you those things to tell you now, virgins belongs to me. This is how you go about it. And when you go about it, even before you start praying, he will answer. Have you ever prayed for a witch in your village to die? Die, 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 die! But you cannot pray. He's living, living, living! It means you are praying in flesh, wasting your time and wasting your windpipe for nothing. Yeah? Yes, and let the Lord tell you to attack that person. And we give you the direction of attacking that person. Your effort and strength is in vain. What are you doing, man? Where is it from? Go live in the manners of praises. And stop doing funny, funny things and drama things. Hey, this revelation, man. Today in the morning, I even stood up in a stuka. Come here, I was a fool. Amen. Am I making sense to someone today?
Yes.
You know, there's a pastor who will live with that pastor in Embakasi. And that pastor, I'm going to match a rope here and I'm going to isn't it? I'm going to wish in a plot. I don't know, I'm going to charm the Ezo Manumba. So that man starts fighting those man. Chawi. Nina Pupu, Chawi. Nina Maliza, Chawi. And I'm going to plot again. Tina Wana, I'm Chawi. The same magic. Jirani, I'm going to magic. Nina Funga, Chawi. So the second of no joy to harm, no joy to harm. So who is fooling him? Praise God. When you may want to say, but after seeing, did the Lord tell you to rebuke those two chariots? No, we are living in the wicked and crooked, with wicked and crooked people. Take them the way they are. I think the Lord gives you the direction on how to deal with them.
Amen.
That's why I was able to be the other way, Lord. Child, you shifted. Ukaenda kwa the Lord, child, you shifted. Ukaenda pale, child. Ulienda kwa kanisa ukapiga vita, ukaona mchawi akapiga vita ukatoka. Ukaenda kwa ingine the same. Ukaenda kwa ingine. No, in the last day, the Bible says that people will seek me, but they will not find me. Wait upon the Lord where you are and see the salvation of God, not your salvation. You can't save yourself. You have to wait until the Lord brings salvation to himself. Moses didn't take the children of Israel, take swords and start attacking. No. He told them to wait because and see the salvation. Because the battle is not theirs. The battle is God's. Amen.
Amen.
You know the Bible says that we are given power and authority to be clothed with the full armor of God. Isn't it? So if you're carrying the full armor of God, and the Lord gives you power and authority to attack, then you have to attack, 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 and then attack again, because victory is guaranteed unto you. But if you are not given authority to attack, I'm telling you, keep quiet. Just praise God. Amen. Because the Lord that we serve lives in the abundance of the praises. Amen.
Amen.
And that's why David said, quicken me unto you, so that I may seek your face. I think the book of Psalms chapter 19 somewhere. Huh? Quicken me unto you, so that I may seek your face. So until the Lord quickens you unto him, there's no way you can seek his face and find it. Amen.
Amen.
And you may just be a religious person, a Pentecostal religious person. The days that kuna wachungaji hapa wanakuambia, I think it's Glamour and Pastor Wash, they will tell you that the church that they used to go to, that people used to clap their hands, the reason that they used to tear the hands of their hands because of clapping, and they are rebuking demons. Eh? But they are coming out of those fellowship and services fully loaded with demons and curses. Right? Because the Lord is not in those clubs. The Bible says, and there was a tremor, but the Lord was not in that tremor. There came fire, but the Lord was not there. Though he is a consuming fire, he was not in that fire. But it is a point that a small, still voice was heard. That's when God came. Not sometimes, the more you think that you are fighting, the more you think that you are destroying, the more you think that you are fasting, is the more you are pulling the Lord away from that battle. Until the stage of a small, still voice comes your way. That's where he responds. If God loves you, he will just deliver you. Doesn't matter who bewitches you. Doesn't matter who is coloring you. Doesn't matter what is affecting and disturbing you. When the Lord loves you, if you have that mark of God, we just do deliverance himself in his own way, in his own time. Wait for it.
Amen.
Amen.
There's another pastor. The same pastor who shifted from one throne to another. Yeah? That pastor when you sit with him, it's about warfare. Nigeno pale, nikapigwa vita. Nigeno pale, ni no, hata wanajeshi wakipigana, sasa ngine hautulia wanakula. Hizi. Kuna pigana na mdei. And that's why you can't keep that gift in you. Isn't it? Because you are always in warfare. You know when you are in warfare, you are using your energy. Yes. You are using your armors. Yes. You are emptying your arsenal. Yeah? Yes, you are always fighting, yeah, throwing bombs, throwing arrows and kadalika, yeah? So at the end of the day, you will become powerless. Why? Because you are using too much energy, you are burning too much calories in the spiritual realm. So you end up becoming exhausted at the end of it. And that's why that gift cannot operate in you. That's why you have to learn. After running, you walk. So you have read that in the Bible. Yes. So walking is the relaxing part of the spiritual life, isn't it? Yeah, you're just rejoicing, yes, and testifying of the good things about your God. Yes, you're just seeing calamity and turning them into goodness. Yes, you're turning your curse into blessings. Yes, you're responding to your haters with good. You're paying back evil with good, yeah? Yes, you're just relaxing in the presence of God. That means you are loading your arsenal. You are loading your powers. Do you remember the story of that woman with the issue of blood? When he touched the robe of Christ, Christ said that some power has run out of me, won't touch me. So when you use your power too much in fighting, in wrestling, in fighting, petty warfare, using your power, you are emptying yourself. And it will take you long fastings for you to regain your power. But some battles, when you assume some battles, by just declaring that I know that my Redeemer lives and holding in spirit, you are keeping power within you. And once you have that power, what will happen? You know, I was seeing the way you were in 70, the president of the Republic of Uganda did in the last campaign, when he was contesting with this opposition leader by the name Tsvangirai, something like that, Tsvangirai. You know what that man did? Yes. Few days to the election, he exposed his arsenal and the elite squad in his military, isn't it? Yes, this is the might of my military and my leadership. Hey, Tsvangirai looked at it, and I said, Papa, I did not make it. Yeah? And that's what he did. He was rigged the election, and Tsvangirai is in power today, isn't it? But what if Tsvangirai were together in Sudan, and together in Kenya, and together in Ethiopia, you know, people are powerless. Tsvangirai, you know, you're not the best, you know, one body leader, isn't it? So let's keep your power. Keep your weapons as you are waiting upon the Lord until the time when the Lord will release you to attack and attack and then attack again. Injury imekuwa kali, yeah? Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
I'm not saying that fighting spiritual warfare is bad, yeah? But just be wise. The Bible says that be wise as a serpent, but as harmless as a dove. Amen.
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 Amen. Yes, when the Lord shows you about things that are happening in your spiritual realm, it means that He loves you. That people who spend millions for them to receive or see revelation. Isn't it? But the Lord is showing you these things free of charge. You have to rejoice, because when the Lord shows you something, it means that yes, He is doing something about it. Just telling you, my daughter, my son, this is what is happening, and I know that it is happening, and I know how to deal with it. Give me time. I'm coming at my appointed time. That is about us. You know, there is a story that I heard when I was a child. I think my sister, Lucy, my firstborn sister, was the one who used to tell us these things when we were still very young. There was a woman who had children. Yeah? In her house. So anything happens in her house, you say that Shetani Ashindwe to frame your Lachini. Shetani Ashindwe. Hey! And the bigger person going on what? Shetani Ashindwe! And he sometimes used to fail to turn onions into golden brown and make them turn into golden black. Yeah? And I said, but Shetani Ashindwe. Not like here. Shetani Ashindwe. So Shetani Ashindwe got the team in that house. At the end of the day, that family was ruined because of Shetani Ashindwe. Anything, like any warfare, anything is Shetani Ashindwe. No! In some weaknesses, rejoice! When someone bewitches you, rejoice in that, hey, he has seen the potential in me, so I'm rejoicing in the Lord, because it's not me who is bewitching, but the Lord in me. The Lord will deal with him, so I have to rejoice because of that person who is bewitching me. He has made me to know and realize my potential. Amen.
Amen.
But those some days, I want to rebuke everything. You know, sometimes when the Lord is opening your spiritual eyes, you will see demons, man, tell me, my friend. You will see magicians. You will see your haters. Isn't it? Do you think that you spend every time you go before the Lord is fighting, cursing, rebuking, fighting, cursing, rebuking, fighting, cursing, rebuking, fighting, cursing, rebuking? When will you pray for blessings to come your way and the light of God to come your way? Yes, we are fighting the powers of darkness. No! When you believe God upon the light of God to come your way? Sometimes it could change after learning what the Lord is saying and start proclaiming the blessings of God in your way. You know that some people, even blessings are running away from them. Isn't it? Not because they are not used. But it is because anytime they speak about fire, upanga, mawe ya Daudi, kuki ya kwenye, I thought he was going to pray about